This man hardly needs an introduction. He's one of Hollywood's biggest stars, not to mention a passionate humanitarian and political activist.
Mr. Clooney,
how are you, my friend?
How are you doing?
Very good.
Thanks so much for doing this.
I'm very happy to do it. Happy to see you.
Thank you. You look very dashy.
Well, look at you.
And I'm happy to see anybody else with gray hair.
I know. At 57, I'm a little older than you.
But you look younger, which actually makes me angry.
Clooney's fame hit new highs last year when he married prominent human rights lawyer Amal Alamuddin.
When somebody told me that I was going to talk to the husband of Amal Alamuddin, I was really excited.
Exactly. Listen, that's all I get anymore.
These days, Mrs. Clooney gets as much attention, if not more, than her husband.
Amal is a human rights lawyer who worked on the Enron case, was an advisor to Kofi Annan regarding Syria, and was selected for a three-person UN commission investigating rules of war violations in the Gaza Strip. So tonight, her husband is getting a Lifetime Achievement Award.
You know, I've had the opportunity to talk to dozens of presidents and heads of state, but I guess no one as famous as you. But I still remember once you said about fame that it had little to do with you.
Sure.
Do you really believe that?
In achieving fame, I think it does. There's so many elements of luck that have to take place. You know, my Aunt Rosemary was very famous for a period of time, a famous singer. And things changed in her career. Rock and roll came around and women singers were suddenly gone. Fame just left. She didn't become less of a singer. It just went away. And for me, it was, I'd been working for 15 years, and then ER came around. And ER, were it picked up for Friday night instead of Thursday night, we wouldn't have been the hit we were. It's that kind of luck that plays. And if not for ER, then I wouldn't have had the career I've had.
I was thinking that maybe you and I could see each other again.
If I'd known you'd find suicide such a turn-on, I would have tried it when we were together.
I'm serious.
You're not on social media right now?
No.
No Twitter?
No.
You said, I don't understand why any famous person would ever be on Twitter.
If you're gonna ask people to pay money to come see you in a movie, they don't need to know your every thought all the time. I think there has to be some element of mystery. There's a real danger when you're really famous. I can have a drink or two at night. I don't need to have an apparatus that in a drunken joke even, I could say something,
late
go to
night.
Sleep, and wake up in the morning and my career be over. It doesn't make sense to me that I would have that weapon available at any point.
I remember you had a meeting with President Barack Obama and you complained, you said, we've stopped living our lives and we're just recording them with our cell phone.
He and I, we were meeting with a bunch of people and everybody was standing here like this. So we're shaking
hands, right?
And they're like this. And there's the president and myself, and we're trying to shake their hands, and they're all like this. And I thought, you know, you can say that you recorded the president of the United States, but you can't say you met him.
That you were there.
Because you're not living your life.
His newest movie, Tomorrowland, is due out in theaters May 22nd.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
And it's a little different from the kind of films he normally does.
So it's been defined as retro-futuristic. Would you want to explain?
I don't know. You take your best shot. You're smarter than me.
Yeah, but it's so interesting, no?
It's
so interesting. Even the film has this optimistic idea behind it.
Why her? Why now?
Because she hasn't given up.
Brad Bird, who's the filmmaker, and Damon, came to me with this idea and this script, and they said, look, news has been very disturbing as of late for the last few years. There's so many things going on in the world that are hard on your heart. They're hard to watch, and you can't fix them all, and you look at what's going on in Syria, or you look at what's going on in the world, and it just keeps hurting. And I think these guys thought, we want to really look at the world and the future in an optimistic way.
Let me ask you about the movie industry. I'm sure many people thought that Kevin Spacey was crazy when he decided to sign up with Netflix to do House of Cards.
Sure, sure.
Do you think that TV is becoming more challenging, more interesting than the movie industry?
It's been happening for a long time. The television has been, I think since The Sopranos really, has been able to really challenge and do things that films used to only have the market on. There's such better television now than there was 5 years ago. There's probably 10 shows, and they're 10 episodes, and they're masterpieces. And you can watch a lot of films that aren't.
Beyond Hollywood, Clooney's passionate about politics. For years, he's been shining a light on the humanitarian crisis in Sudan's Darfur region. He's also been an avid supporter of President Obama. So what does he think about Hillary?
Now, you talked about Hillary Clinton. I think she's in town, by the way.
Oh, she is?
Yeah. Are you gonna
be? You'll know because all the traffic will be stopped.
Well, maybe it's because of you. But are you going to be helping her for 2016?
Sure, and whatever she wants, whatever way I can help. I think that she's a tremendous candidate, and I know her, mm-hmm. and I think the world of her, and I think that I would be very happy if she were president.
But you said in 2008 that she was the most polarizing figure in American politics.
She was a polarizing figure in American politics because at the time, mm-hmm. I felt that there were as many people that would show up to vote against her mm-hmm. because she was Hillary. I think she's ready to be president. I think she could have been a wonderful president before. I just thought that she'd have a hard time beating the people who were going to show up to vote against her. And I don't think that that's the truth anymore.
On the Republican side, you have it's much more open. Mm-hmm. So if you had to play one of the candidates, who would you want to play?
Play? Oh, God, I don't know. Well, Rubio, Chris Christie, and I could just eat all day. I would feel good. Do you know, I'll tell you an interesting uh-huh. thing, though. They have a very tough path.
Yeah.
Because as you'll see with Bernie Sanders, we'll be pulling Hillary to the left. The pull to the right's pretty extreme, pretty hard right now. And so it's going to be an interesting, it's going to be a very difficult time. If you look at, you know, they're going to have to come up with a candidate that isn't a truly polarizing candidate. And that's a very tough way to go.
For the most part, Clooney steers clear of drama with the tabloids. But last year, one report hit a nerve. The Daily Mail reported that his wife's mother opposed their marriage because Amal was marrying outside of her Druze faith, a Middle Eastern religious sect. He responded with a scathing op-ed published in USA Today.
They were trying to foment a religious hatred by saying that my wife is Druze, which she's not, and they had written before that she wasn't, but that doesn't matter, and that because she was marrying outside her faith, that that the Druze were willing to execute the bride, to kill my wife, kill my fiance at the time. Well, first of all, it's not true, and that's not what goes on. But secondly, it's a dangerous thing in the world we live in right now, in the world that my wife and I live in. I don't pick fights often with them. 99% of the stuff that comes out, I just let it, you know, there's a story but every day. Yeah. But that one was different. That's actually threatening, putting my wife in danger.
And finally, I couldn't resist asking how he's managed to age so well.
Any tips for gray hair? Or about
you look so good.
Or aging gracefully?
What is it? How? Because you're the most graceful aging guy I've ever seen in my life.
Thank you so much, George.
85 years old, this man.
Exactly. 86.
88.
Thank you so much.